before we could get to the black walnut logs, we have one log on the mill. So I figure I'd go ahead and get this one cut up into boards. And I honestly think this is going to be a really good board. Poplar, this is a poplar log. I think it's going to be really nice inside. So I thought I'd bring you guys along for this cut. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to get the cut. I go through this a good bit. What happened? The belt come off. So I'll get the tools, loosen it up, and tighten them back down. Okay, I got the belt, or I got the blade back on and tightened down. We'll just give it a shot again. This does this actually quite a bit, but it does produce wood, so. One day we'll take our time and do some work to it, but right now I just don't have time to do it. And I don't think I should have to be working on it, but whatever. All right, we got two really, really nice pieces of wood. We got about four of them with purple in them, but these ones here are definitely the nicest. Look at that. Now this would make a nice coffee table. I'm actually cutting these five quarters, so they will make a nice coffee table. We're gonna get these stacked up so they can dry. I'll give you a little close up of what they look like. Now I'm pretty certain that the color will stay on there once you put a clear coat on there, something like that. That's gonna help keep it in there. We actually wasn't even gonna cut this piece of wood. It was over there on the other side of the property. And I said, why not? Because the bottom piece had some of that purple in it, and I thought maybe this one here looked a little, I thought, rotten. But as you can see, it's not rotten. We got some beautiful wood there. So this is just one step closer to putting that walnut on the sawmill. This one had to be cut up before you can get it on there, so I figured I'd do it on video. So I would like to tell everybody, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Leave me thumbs up, thumbs down, or a comment if you'd like.